Hey everyone, welcome back to another Counterside video, and today we will be discussing the review for Liyumi and also discuss her build. But before that, if you want an updated Counterside videos, please hit the subscribe button down below. Okay, so for Liyumi, she is actually an SSR. Her banner is actually up right now. I would highly suggest that you guys pull for her and see what I mean in the next few minutes. Also, she also has a 3 deployment cost, which is actually very good for a defender, very cost efficient, and more or less very versatile in terms if you want to spam her. She is again a defender, ground type, and ground attack. She isn't able to attack units in the air. And her profile, she is actually a defender of SWAT 4. So for her stats, we will start with her combat power, which is 10,362. HP, which is 48,783, which is actually considered above average for all the units in Counterside. Attack is 3,827, which is below average. But again, it is second among defenders. She is second among defenders for attack in Counterside. And also for her defense, she has 688, which is below average again. Crit hit, which is 299, and hit, which is 235, which both are low. And her evasion, which is 1004, is actually the highest and also the highest among defenders. Okay, so that is why she is actually very good. Very good stat for HP and very good stat for evasion. So for her skills here, so for her basic skill, so it's a basic attack. Swings a sword materialized out of her watch and inflicts AoE damage. That is good because it's AoE. Levels 2 to 5 are just a plus 5% in her basic attack. And also for her passive skill, so it's called Out of the Way. Confidently charges without thinking twice, increases evasion by 50% for 20 seconds when deployed. This is actually where she is good, because once you deploy her, whatever stat that she has for evasion, like for example, we saw there in her stat, her max would be, let's say if she doesn't have any boost, it's 1004. So another 50% of that once she is deployed for 20 seconds. So again, she would have enough time to charge any opponent on the other side and reaching them, especially if they are rangers or if they are snipers. She would definitely have enough time to dodge and to evade their attacks, because this runs for 30 seconds. And also for this passive, levels 1 to 5. So levels 1 to 4 would be damage taken is going to be a cumulative of 8%. So 2, 2, and 4. So they're all minus 4, 2, and minus 2. And for level 5, passive buffs also decreases damage taken by 15%. Again, she's very tanky. Damage reduction, evasion, and high HP. Let's move on to her special skill. So Spinning Edge, it's actually it has a 16 second cooldown, valid hits at 2, spins and moves toward the target, inflicting AoE damage. Enemies lose 30% of hit, which is actually very good, and focuses their attacks on her for 5 seconds. So more or less, she taunts the enemies, forcing them to attack her, and also losing their hit and decreasing their hit. So cooldown is going to be a max from level 2 to 4, 4 seconds, which the 16 seconds would be turned to 12 seconds. And level 5 debuff also decreases enemies' attack by 10%. So a lot of buffs and debuffs for her. That is why I've had a hard time killing her in PvP. And let's go to her ultimate skill, which is Dual Blade. So you have here 52 seconds cooldown, so valid hits again too. Divides her sword into two and swings them with incredible speed, inflicting AoE damage on surrounding targets. Increases evasion by 50% for 15 seconds after the skill's effect. So again, another damage dealing ultimate with AoE damage, and also increases again evasion by 50% for 15 seconds after this skill's effect. And for levels 2 to 4, there's an increase of damage of total of plus 25. But for her level 5, buff also increases damage taken by 10%. Okay, so my overall thoughts on her skills. She actually has a lot of buffs on herself and debuffs on the enemies. That is why she is very hard to kill, mostly towards evasion and decrease in damage. So that's it. She actually has above average HP, which is actually hard to kill. So again, that is why, if you notice, you cannot, you know, it's really hard for you to take her down one-on-one, especially if you don't have, you know, if you don't have that much damage to deal to her, or if you could hit her in any way. So more or less, again guys, very very solid hero or character. Let's move on to her gear. For my Liu Bi, I'm sorry, I don't have her yet at 6-star, but more or less, I decided to go with evasion set for your attack and for your, this is going to be your armor. So I'm going with evasion set because I wanted to increase her evasion. Actually, at level 82, her evasion is already at 1029, so it's already a bump of plus 207. But again, if I increase her level and 6-star her, this would increase the most. Also for her gear, if you could actually increase her HP, but again, her HP is actually good already at above average. Okay, so for her for her accessory, more or less I would go with either anti-ranger, because actually she is actually very vulnerable to rangers, and also I would probably give her additional evasion if I can. So for evasion or another set for HP, so that I would bump up again her HP. More or less, you have the two skills that you can bump up. What I suggest with gear is HP and evasion. That is it for her gear. And let us see her skills in action. Okay, so for Liu Mi, more or less, she has her increased evasion by 50% during deployment. So again, she would be very good to deploy as early as possible because she would be your lead defender. Probably another backup for either a striker or another defender, then the rest are back units. Again, for her skill, let us see her ultimate. So dual blade, very nice animation, very clean, and that spinning skill, I actually forgot the name. It actually is good in terms of animation. Okay, so my final thoughts for Liu Mi. Again, I was actually very fortunate to get her on the second pull. So I only spent around 20 recruitment employment contracts. I was very fortunate not to pity the banner. But again, if you guys have the recruitment contracts left, please do summon for her. Her banner is actually up to, let's take a look at the banners that we have. So here it is. So she has actually 10 days left on this banner, and I would suggest you guys pull for her. She is a very good defender, very meta in PvP, and actually would be good as well in your PvE contents. But she will shine most in PvP. Right now, she is actually a headache to deal with because I haven't had mine leveled up that much and geared as well. But again, you will never regret getting her. She's a very good tank, very good in evasion, very good in HP, and also very good in debuffs for the enemy and buffs for herself. So guys, more or less, thank you for staying to the end of this video. Also, please consider subscribing, and also don't forget to check out that bell icon and leave a like in this video. Anyway guys, for comments, please put them down in the comment section below, and also stay safe, take care. This is the Warden, and I'm out of here.